So in a closed system like this, we have a pretty good biosecurity plan. That means that, you know, we can buffer against the other sorts of pathogens and things like that coming into the system. However, once a disease enters into a system, especially for the fish and for the plants, it's really hard to get rid of. And the issues with that is that any sort of treatment that's going to help the fish out will either harm your bacteria and your biofilter, or it'll harm the plants directly, and that same sort of relationship with the plants as well. Typically, in an aquaponic system, you are just as susceptible as you are out in the environment with regard to insect pests. If you're growing indoors in a greenhouse like we are, you have more control over that environment, but you really need to be having good pest management practices in place in order for you to mitigate any losses, because, you know, we have had issues with caterpillars coming in here and actually ate all of our crop of lettuce and basil within a couple of days, and then we had no product to go to market. That can be a huge issue in the industry. All right, specifically for the caterpillar issue, we actually used a product called BT, which is sort of a deadly disease for the caterpillars. That's actually sort of an organic treatment that doesn't affect the fish, so we're actually able to spray those. But in general, you're not able to use any sort of herbicide treatment for your fish, but some things that do work, maybe a couple of different essential oils from plants that organic producers might use. Also, we use things like the diatomaceous earth, which actually can take care of a lot of different young individual types of insects by desiccating their bodies. We use things like these pest traps, sticky traps, able to capture some of our issues here. And also we use sort of an insect trap that uses an herbicide, but it's actually, or insecticide rather, but it's not introduced into the system at all and sort of contained away from the plants. So we use also some biological controls in these systems, that meaning other sorts of parasitic insects or predators, like parasitic wasps, for example, will lay their eggs inside of some other critters, and then they'll kill those that way. You can use ladybugs. Lacewings is another example of an insect that's going to actually kill off some of the other the other leaf-eating insects like white flies and that sort of thing that we have in here. So there's a range of building infrastructures that might work for a producer, and it depends on if you want to be a hobbyist or if you want to be a really commercial producer.